Here's what's going on.
Hey man, how you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. So the thing that I always struggle with, so when you first get a script and you talk and work with the director and you start, at least for me, I start kind of building the character on my own. But then I arrive to work and there are of course other actors that I'm meant to interact with who have created their own characters and their own
Bullshit.
stories.
Yeah.
And then you're trying to figure out how do we now mix together and how do we work with each other? So what was that process like? Because there's so many wonderful people that you worked with in this film, who all had very distinct characters. What was the rehearsal process like?
Yeah, that's the amazing thing about this. We didn't do any rehearsal. And I think partly because I was so kind of scared by the shit, am I gonna, I'm gonna play the drums and sign language and also just I don't know anything about this world of this music and I think emotionally it was a lot more raw than anything I'd done emotionally for a few years. And I was like, can I get it? Because of that, I wanted rehearsal. But the director Darius was actually great in saying that, you know what, I just want you to kind of take a risk this time and not do some of those things that you normally do, not do those rehearsals. We'll do shitload of preparation, kind of almost living as the character in a way in terms of the stuff I'm doing every day for such a long time. But don't have rehearsal. Instead, what we had was a process of, and this put us all us actors kind of in the same world, like you're saying, put us on the same pages. We almost lived through the process together. So Olivia Cook, who plays Lou, she was learning the guitar and loop pedals and that specific kind of screaming vocal style in noise music. The same time I was learning the drums, we'd do band rehearsals together. I'm doing that band rehearsals, the drumming, the sign language. Living in a deaf community, so you start living into this process, and you start adding other actors into it. And Darius was also great in saying that we should shoot chronologically, and so you feel like you're living through it. In a weird way, you're not like, okay, this person's coming in with this idea of it in their head, and this person's coming in. It's like, to some extent, you kind of all gone through that journey together. So it really helped, and it created a kind of almost like a family vibe, I think that's the most beautiful thing about this one is that there's that like little team doing this against the odds, kind of feeling. It kind of gels everyone. It wasn't the kind of movie where everyone has trailers to go back to and they're doing their own thing. We were all just there, like doing a couple of takes for each scene and just living through it in scene order, which is great.
So, when the characters like coming to you, and maybe you're aware of this, maybe you're not, I don't know, I rarely am, but do you build it from the outside in or inside out, or is it just happening simultaneously? And do you, so like I'm thinking about like your haircut, the dye, the tattoos, like did you make those decisions well in advance? Or was it something that was just coming up like, you should shake your head no. What is it?
Nah. I mean, I kind of just something that helps me a bit is research and just meeting people and hanging out with them. And that's kind of partly what I love about this. There is a kind of social aspect to it. You're part of a team, on set. I know, I guess it just reminds me of like, when I was a kid doing like the school play, that camaraderie. And so I kind of track people down who I can basically just stalk and hang out with for a while. And I just hang out with them and I often record them as well because I very rarely get asked to kind of play my own accent. So I kind of record them and I just hang out with them and interview them. And they introduce me to their friends. Then we go to stuff. And from there, I kind of start getting ideas and noticing patterns. Like something that was interesting to me in the world of punk and metal, and it was obviously tattoos and all that, but this idea of kind of modifying yourself. This idea of like seizing ownership of your body and your identity in like a really, sometimes aggressive or defiant way.
We rarely get the opportunity to do this, but I think every film, I feel like you should be able to do like additional shooting for several weeks. I always feel that it takes me at least 2 weeks before like I start settling and letting it come to me more.
I massively agree with that. But you know, there's I don't know. It's like that was something that just kind of. I mean, I just had crazy insomnia, I remember, throughout that whole first week of shooting. I kind of slept like an hour and a half a night if I slept. And I became convinced that it was the mattress. I thought that they've got me on these fucked up mattresses, and maybe they're doing this on purpose to try to like mess with my head and get me on edge. And I went out, and over that first week, I bought two new mattresses. I bought another mattress on day three, didn't work out. I bought another mattress. You know, there's that kind of adrenaline. I don't know if you get this before the first night of shooting where you just basically can't sleep. And it does take you time to settle, but because I didn't have my usual comfort blanket of checking playback or whatever, and it was a quick shoot, in a way I didn't get to settle. And what was interesting about Darius is he didn't want me to settle. You know, every now and again you work with that director who will give you that space to just make a lot of mistakes and to just gallop for a bit before you find it, to not know if you find it. So yeah, I feel like a lot of the process depends on who you're working with, right? And that's the thing that's crazy. I feel like there's no template. Every time you do a film, at least every time I do one, I'm like, feel like starting from scratch a little bit in terms of how, you know, what's the process? How do I do this? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
What the fuck's up with the donut?
I don't like them.
Is that something that just came up?
I think something I've noticed spending more time in America is there's a big junk food thing. I want to send a message to kids. You know, I don't know, man. Like, yeah, it just kind of came up. It just came up. I was just like, I don't know. It was looking to be funny. I don't know what to say, you know. It just...
But why did you have the donut in the first? Because it's something that's like, he gets into this kind of like addict habit, this ritual of kind of going upstairs to write with a cup of coffee and a donut. But I became obsessed with this donut, wondering where this came from. Because it's not like it was anything that had been introduced earlier in the film that I was aware of. Did I miss something?
It's an Easter egg. It's a sequel. It's all about the donut, man. You're missing out on. I guess, I'm not analyzing. At the time, you're not thinking any of this stuff, and just, you know, whatever, your body's reacting to certain things and thoughts are coming in, you're doing shit. But the funny thing is that when you look back at it, it actually makes a lot of sense, because the donut is a kind of peace offering from Joe.
Honestly, man, I know we worked together before. We met each other. We've known each other. But you're really extraordinary in this movie. But really, in all of your work, I mean, we were in Sisters Brothers together, and I remember just being I couldn't understand. I would look at the lines, I'd say, well, this scene's impossible. Like, how? No, it's just impossible. You can't say any of that stuff and make it sound authentic, because it'd be impossible. You do these scenes. I couldn't figure it out. There's just such honesty to work. And it's really meaningful, and you're just brilliant in this movie.
Thank you, man. That means the world, bro. Appreciate it, man. You know, I how I feel about your work. I won't embarrass you now by telling you how much I love it. But I remember when we were on the set for Sisters Brothers, once or twice you came up to me and you kind of trying to encourage me. And you know, I think like all of us, that we can all feel a bit vulnerable when we're working and stuff. And you were like, that was great. And I remember just thinking, I think he's making fun of me. Fuck. What the fuck? Why would he do that? Just is such a kind of weird tells me. And then you kind of did it again. I was like, oh no, I think he's just being nice. Okay, that's cool. Thank you. So I appreciated it, man. It was, yeah, Thank you.
Yeah. Really, this, I think, so, you know, as an actor, you probably can't, I don't know if you do this, but, you know, when I watch movies, I just imagine, like, sometimes I watch movies and I imagine different kind of line readings or coming from like in a different emotional place when I said something, if I were to play the character. And every once in a while, you watch films and actors where you can't think of an alternative. Just the way that they say that line or behave in that moment is the only way that you can now imagine it being portrayed. And that was the feeling that I had with you in this film.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks for talking to me. It was really cool to hear how you think about the character and the film and building it. So thanks for taking time and talking to me.
Thank you, man. Thank you for taking out the time. And I'm just so glad you're into it, man. You know, I think that is one thing that is cool to, like, you know, for people who inspire you to kind of say that they connected to something, it feels good, man. So thank you. I appreciate you, bro.
Yeah, no, it's really a great performance, truly.